Hey, have you ever said anything that, like, while the words were coming out of your mouth, you knew you shouldn't have said it, but now it's too late? Yeah, well, that happened to me. And I made a huge mistake in trying to read an email on my phone. Should have waited, wasn't urgent, but I read the email on my phone without my glasses on. Thought I knew what it said, and it wasn't good. And I fired off a quick little no-nonsense, pretty terse, not all the way rude, but pretty terse response. Oh boy. So then, a little while later, when I had my glasses on, I picked it back up and I looked at it and I thought, oh no. Ow, it didn't say what I thought it did. Oh boy, now I've done it. Yep, I did it. The lady who wrote not one, but two books about kindness. Not one, but two books about love. Yes, my second book about love is going to be released soon. Yeah. So I immediately sent an email, apologized, explained what I had done, and I misread it, and I misunderstood, and I'm sorry. And then, you know what? I felt bad about myself because I thought, I should know better by now. But, you know, I thought, okay, this is a great lesson, and I'm going to share this with everybody. I think that when we recognize that there's a little bit of jerk, joker, or jackass in each of us, it's easier to forgive other people when their jerk, joker, or jackass comes through. And the best thing to do when we've let those words slip out of our mouth that we can't grab and put back in is to say we're sorry, recognize our jerkiness, and then give ourselves mercy and move on. Like, don't walk around beating yourself up. And this is true whether or not the other person accepts your response, your apology. We accept our responsibility for what we do, and we try to do better in the future. And that's it. And then that models that for everybody within our influence. So if you've done or said something that was jerky or jokery or jackassery, forgive yourself, ask for forgiveness, and let's all move on.